My name is Lazarus Nape. I'm a senior HRD practitioner on TMM site, Trackless Mobile Machineries. The mine started in 2007. It's producing platinum. The mine started to be productive in 2008. We have the simulators for now 4 years. I think it's 4 years now. I've got the LHD, I've got the roof bolter, I've got the drill rig, and then we've got the UV. According to my process flow, I start by giving them theory in the class to understand what they are going to see. Then the simulator is the next step to reduce their shock before they can get into the real machine. The simulators increase the uptime by 40%, which now also reduces the injuries, the lost times, and then the fatalities that the mine can get exposed to. On the maintenance side, there's a lot of money that is being used, like 5 to 6 million over a year. So just imagine if you don't have proper trained operators, what's going to happen? There are a lot of operators that were sent for retraining because they couldn't perform their operations well underground. Well, what we do, we just bring them for retraining on a simulator first to see what the complaints is all about. I'm running now for 2 years. We've never had a fatality in the machine. If you have a simulator, it makes your life easier, your facilitator's job easier. Other operators, they are not good in speaking English. You can prove their competency through RPL, and you can use the simulator to do that. Since I've started working with the simulators, here at Eland that I see it, it saves a lot for the company, and it gives a clear picture of training, of what you are doing as a trainer. And your improvement, and it shows where even if you are a facilitator, it shows you where to improve. That's all I can say about the simulator.